In this video, I'm going to show you how to stream to Twitch, YouTube gaming, Hitbox, and much more at the same time. And it's completely free. Let's get right into it. One of the questions I get asked a lot is, what service should I stream to? And the answer that I give is usually Twitch or YouTube gaming, but there's a lot of merit in other services such as Hitbox, BeamPro, and a few others. Usually, my answer depends on what the goal of the streamer is, but with the service Restream.io, there's almost no reason you have to choose a specific platform anymore. With Restream.io, you can stream to almost any popular streaming service quickly and easily. The best part with a service like this is that it won't put any more stress on your PC hardware or your bandwidth. So basically, you'll stream your feed to Restream.io servers, which then sends it out to the other platforms that you choose. Also, with their redesign and the addition of their Restream chat app that compiles all of your chat messages into one easy program, this service went from something that I thought was interesting to a service that I think is a must try for any new streamer. We'll talk more about Restream Chat in the next video, so make sure to subscribe to watch that. To start, let's head over to Restream.io and sign up for an account. Once your account is created and you're logged in, you'll be prompted with the ability to add a channel. Let's click Add Channel and we'll be presented with all the platforms that are supported. As you can see, it's quite a list. Twitch, YouTube Gaming, BeamPro, and over 25 more. If we scroll down a bit, we can even see the ability to double up as well as stream to a custom RTMP. Anyways, I'm going to add in Twitch and Hitbox for this video, but adding in more channels is the same for almost every service. Before I continue, I want to mention that I have already created accounts at Twitch and Hitbox, as well as the other services that I plan to add. So if you don't have an account with these individual platforms, make sure that you create each account before continuing. Adding a channel works the same for all the platforms as I mentioned, so all we need to do is click the service you want to add, hit connect, and authorize it. This may require you to log into the platform. And by the way, when I say platform, I mean something like Twitch, YouTube Gaming, etc. Anyways, once you've added in one channel, you can click the Add Channel button again at the top right to choose an additional service. For any new streamer, I'd recommend starting out with Twitch, YouTube Gaming, Hitbox, and BeamPro. When you're all done adding in the channels that you'd like, you'll then notice that you actually have the option to update your stream title, but this only works with Twitch and YouTube right now. Now, we need to configure OBS Studio to stream to Restream.io. To do so, let's select the server that's closest to our location on the right side of our Restream dashboard. In my case, I'm going to pick Dallas, Texas. Now, we need to copy our stream key. Go ahead and click inside the stream key box and copy this entire string of characters. If you ever need to reset your key, this refresh button will do that for you. With OBS Studio open, let's go into the settings and click the Stream tab. Under the Service dropdown, select Restream.io, then match the server with the one that you selected in the Restream dashboard, then just paste in your stream key. Hit Apply and then OK to close the settings, and that's it. Your other settings inside of OBS Studio can be left the same as if you're streaming directly to Twitch. If you need more help on that, make sure to check out my other videos on this topic. Once I hit Start Streaming, Restream will attempt to connect to all the services that I listed and then show their status, such as connecting, online, or offline. As I mentioned earlier in this video, they also have a program that compiles all of your chat messages from each channel that you've added. We'll be checking that out in our next video in full detail, but basically, once you install it, run it, and log into this app, you'll see all of your messages in one place. We can even add this into OBS Studio as well, so that our viewers can keep up on what's happening across all of our platforms. For the last part of this video, I want to quickly address a concern of mine when using a service like this. I've been impressed so far with this service, but I feel like I should point out a few things. In terms of the reliability of Restream, I've only had a short time to test out the service, and it's been great so far. But there is a possibility of it going down for maintenance, servers being overloaded, problems with the platform APIs, or other various reasons for it not to work. So in case of emergency, you may want to be prepared to connect to the platform of your choice directly. I also noticed that sometimes it takes a bit of time to connect all the services at once, so some kind of intro type screen is recommended until all of your channels show that they're online. The delay is actually quite reasonable, where it's been around 8 to 10 seconds for my stream to be shown on Twitch or YouTube. Lastly, if you're a partnered streamer with Twitch, you may not be able to broadcast to multiple platforms as per your agreement with Twitch. If you're not partnered, then don't worry about this. Anyways, this program impressed me quite a bit. Last time I found something like this that was this easy to use and this well designed was probably Discord. So let me know in the comments below if you have any questions about setting it up or how your experience with it has been so far. If you like this video, please give it a like and make sure to subscribe to Nerd or Die for more great streaming and video game related content. Thanks for watching.